I think the first Human Centipede film, the idea was so gross, and Tom really sort of captured that, and Dieter's performance just really holds you in there. I think with Human Centipede 2, with Tom responding to the fans and they're kind of saying it, what the first one wasn't that gory, and Tom going completely OTT with the second one, but keeping it dark and kind of depressing in a way, but keeping the humour in there. I think that's it's become this generation's Texas Chainsaw Massacre, which again has humour, but it's kind of very dark. I think it's the film a lot of kids and teenagers dare each other to see. I mean, I've had lots of people come up to me pretending to have seen it, and it's when you talk to them, it's obvious they haven't. But everyone kind of wants to be one of the people that has seen it, so that's good. So,
how do you feel about specifically the censorship debate that the films variously provoked?
Well, with Human Centipede 2, it was interesting because I kind of grew up in the video nasties era. I was a teen, 11, 12 when it all sort of came about. And it's kind of interesting to go from having a kind of academic interest from growing up with that into actually being at the centre of the storm with Human Centipede 2. So it's kind of interesting to note that I think the thing that caused the most controversy, or that fueled the controversy, was the BBFC press release. I have no problem with the BBFC rejecting or refusing to certificate a film, but I thought the press release went beyond the remit of the BBFC. That's what triggered campaigns in other countries as well. Australia, the Christian group Family Voice Australia wanted to ban the film because of the BBFC press release. So, I think when people say that it's all good publicity, it's not. It's kind of there's good and bad aspects to it. So.